channel. So today we will be discussing phrasal verbs. So what are phrasal verbs? They contain one or two elements that are also called particles plus a main verb. So these one or two particles can be either prepositions or adverbs. In adverbs, we can say give up. Give up means to stop something. But when we add never in front of it, it means that we're gonna continue something. Like in the example, never give up learning English. And then in prepositions, we can say wish for. I wish for new shoes. So in a phrasal verb, they can also be two particles, just like in look up to. Many kids look up to Superman. Look up to means to become somebody. It's not looking up to somebody. So phrasal verbs are of two types, transitive and intransitive. Intransitive, we have two types, separable and inseparable. Separable. First, separable. The direct object can be placed within the phrasal verb, just like in put on. I put on my jacket. We can also say, I put my jacket on. Both ways are meaningful. Both ways are meaningful. That's why put on is a separable transitive phrasal verb. And inseparable, there is a note, a very important note. When the direct object is a pronoun, like it, her, she, them, it always needs to be in between, within the phrasal verb. Like, I put it on. We can't say, I put on it. And then in inseparable, we can't separate the phrasal verb. Just like in look up to and run out of. We can say, I ran out of gas. We can't say something else. It will be meaningless. In transitive, we do not need a direct object. Just like in broke up. Broke up is the past form of break up. And break up means the end of a relationship or partnership. Just like in the sentence, I and my partner broke up. So sad. And most importantly, we need to know what the phrasal verb actually means. Just like in look up to. Look up to means to become somebody, not to look up. I'm going to give you a few examples. Put away. You're not going to put away something. You're going to set something neatly. Just like in the example, please put away your clothes. And this is separable, so we can also say, please put your clothes away. Try on. Try on means to wear something and see whether you want it or not. Try this on. Write down. Next is write down. So it's not like you're writing on the floor down, but you're writing somewhere, like in a notebook. Write your name down. It is separable, so we can also say, write down your name. Work out. So it has two meanings. One is to exercise, and one is to succeed. In exercise, we can say, I like to work out with weights. And in succeeding, we can say, well done. The plan really worked out. Now, here are a few examples. Take back. It means you're not taking back
I'm just kidding. I take it back.
Please, you're taking the sentence back. You don't want it to spread any longer. And then get up. So you can get up to your feet or you can get up from the bed. Go out. You can go out of the house. And then put away, as I explained. Work out. Hang out. It doesn't mean hanging something. It just means you're having a nice time with your friends or family. Catch up. You're not gonna catch anything. Catch up means to get along with somebody who you haven't seen since a while. Just like, I need to catch up with my friend. And you know what? There's also a joke with ketchup. Ketchup! Try on and write down. So there are fewer examples like throw away. You're gonna throw it away. You don't need it any longer. And the last one, look forward to. So I hope you guys like, share, subscribe and enjoy this video. Also, if you like this video, put a thumbs up in the comments down below. Hopefully it was helpful. Bye!